Check it out. Today I'm bringing you a review of the MTN Street Paint. I have a nice variety of both the markers and mops that the Street Paint is offered in. MTN Street Paint is a permanent paint that is designed to have high opacity, allowing for great surface coverage, while also having a thin enough body to produce drips while using mops. There are a total of 12 different colors offered in the Street Paint line, but I did notice some of these colors are only available in specific marker or mop variations. There are 10 colors available across the board, and then the additional 2 colors come from the silver and gold that are offered in the 8 and 15 millimeter marker options. The 8 millimeter marker offers an awesome rounded bullet tip nib, while the 15 millimeter features a square nib with a slightly chamfered edge. Both nibs were definitely on the stiff side coming out of the box, and which made them take a little bit longer than normal to pump up. As for the mops, there are 2 sizes available, a 10mm and an 18mm. The 10mm comes with 30 milliliters of paint, and the 18mm comes with 90 milliliters of paint. The nibs on these mops felt very traditional, so we'll have to see how they stand up to a rough surface. The last variation on the MTN Street Paint is a 200 milliliter refill bottle. These bottles feature a pop top and an adequately sized squirt hole for refilling. This avoids the need of a funnel or any additional tools when even refilling the smaller markers. I find this as a major bonus with the refill bottle. I like that MTN is keeping the process as easy as possible. All of the supplies featured in this video were provided by SprayPlanet.com. You can save 10% on any order at SprayPlanet when you use the coupon code SIVEFUN. You'll find everything Montana Colors related, and this includes the markers shown here, as well as spray paint caps and tons of accessories. Be sure to check out their site, it'll be linked in the description of the video. The support from SprayPlanet is tremendously helpful for making these product review videos, but as always, the opinions expressed here are solely based on how the supplies performed while I use them. Starting the review off on some paper, these mops quickly showed their dripping abilities. The soft body of the mop made squeezing the marker rather easy, but it did not make an excessive amount of paint come out. The pressure needed to produce an ample flow rate was a really smooth combination that gave drips with every letter. These mops were so great at dripping, it made it rather difficult to tag without making any drips. The vertical surface let the drips run freely, so getting a tag without any drips will take some extra care. Each tag came out with more than enough coverage on the white surface, but I'll be testing this on some darker surfaces later to find out if it holds true across the board. If you lighten up on squeezing the mop body to reduce or remove the dripping, you'll have to take additional care to make sure there's enough paint being applied to the surface. I never got close to streaking, but as you squeeze less, the chances increase drastically. After all, tags with drips are better purpose for when using the markers, so for the time being, let's keep these drips flowing. Moving on to a painted piece of poster board, the mops seemed to excel even more than on the paper. The smooth surface allowed my tags to glide along, while also still holding the colors excellently. Sometimes a smooth surface does not hold onto the paint as well, so it actually pulls away some of the paint while you're writing, but the MTN Street Paint held on great, and there wasn't any streaking. This gives me really good hope for using these on a metal surface. The 90mm YouTube tag definitely used a fair amount of the UFO green from its bottle. The drips were very modest, so I don't see the mops running empty very quickly. You may notice a slightly lighter application of paint in the bottom of the T and on the back side of the E. My tag was moving faster in these areas, while I was not squeezing enough to make these portions drip. So be careful that there's enough paint being applied like I mentioned before. This realistically shouldn't slow down a normal tag, but it's something to keep in mind. You may not be able to get the speed of an alcohol-based ink out of these paints, but I really never felt restricted and needed to move slower at any point while using them. The hard nib of the marker was a little spotty on the concrete wall. It appears that the combination of the smooth paint and the variations in the surface height don't allow the nib to make contact with every point on the wall. I will revisit this with some of the other colors and see if it holds true. In the meantime, the mops wrote nearly all the same on the wall as they did on the poster board. The mops ate up all the divots along its path, filling any uneven surface with ease. The nib showed that they could work into the cracks of the wall without catching or ripping during a tag. I wouldn't go as far to say go after a bare brick wall, but smoother concrete should be no issue with street paint mops. Since the surface was completely non-porous, the drips were nice and long, and rather consistent in length. This shows that it's pretty easy to keep a consistent pressure on the mop. Readdressing the marker performance on the wall, I found that after breaking in the nibs a little bit, they began to write quite a bit better. The only variation in this tag is found where there is a deep pit and the nib can't actually reach the surface. the tags were a little light on how much paint they applied to the surface, you're going to want to make sure to rough the nib up a little bit to break it in. Deliberately fraying them should help to grab the slick surface a little bit better. Like I said originally, these are pretty hard nibs, so if there's not enough friction between them and a surface, no paint will actually be pulled from the marker. Fraying them will increase the size of the nib quite a bit, so start off with a little bit and work your way up to what feels right. The 8mm bullet tip nib wrote amazing on the metal sheet. The tag truly coasted along while providing a completely opaque line. I can always say the bullet tip is best suited on the metal surface. I really do enjoy the rounded nib for tags of this size because you can still quite clearly see the circle shape at the end of each line. Even while trying to keep my drips reserved, the mops were equally as great and smooth as the marker. There was no pitting or streaking either, which means the paint was grabbing the surface quite well. The opacity on even the light yellow showed no signs of the metal below it, so I would highly recommend these paints on a metal surface application. A slight drawback to paint is that it's not going to stain a metal surface. Paint thinner or mineral spirits and a paper towel took these off with a couple of passes, with little scrubbing. So get creative and be sure to beat the buff in other ways with the MTN street paint. Moving on to a piece of plywood, I found the upper limit of how deep of a groove the mop could actually reach into. At the top of the S, you can see a groove that is about an eighth of an inch deep. The nib glided over without much notice, but it was not able to actually put any paint down into it. The rest of the tag was totally unfazed by the wood, so I wouldn't knock it too heavily for this. I don't know if anything besides a larger sponge tip mop would have actually been able to get into these deeper grooves. The 30mm mop seemed to have even less of an issue with these grooves. The tags seemed nearly identical to the smooth poster board and the concrete wall. Similarly, the bullet tip, chrome, and black were soft enough to reach into the surface and give a consistent tag. Unfortunately, the 15mm square tip struggled much in the same way as the first concrete tag on the groove surface. While using the marker on paper, you can see a very mild difference in how much paint is actually applied. At the beginning of each stroke, there's a nice opaque application, and as you write, it becomes slightly lighter. But at no point is there really any concern about streaking. This paint variation means I'm writing faster than the nib and valve are supplying paint to the end of the marker. I saw similar signs of this with the bullet tip nib. I can only continue to speculate that further breaking the nibs will help with the flow of these markers, but it's not very fitting to have to alter a product in the review video, so I'll most likely have to do a follow-up video that can further explain the topic. The hardware of the 15mm marker could definitely use some work before I would consider it perfect. The street paint itself, however, was clearly able to work flawlessly in one way or another on all of these surfaces. I would also give the 8mm marker a better rating, as it only showed the smallest amount of streaking on the paper application. And other than that, it was an absolute killer on the sheet metal. The mops really speak for themselves throughout the streakless performance on everything I threw at them. The colors all stayed true and vibrant, while keeping the grips oh so prevalent. I never felt like the drips were too much or too little, they were a very modest size, and I never found them running too thin either. The nibs on the mops also never showed any signs of spitting, which can occur when you squeeze the body too much and you're actually forcing paint out of the tip. This shows that the valve nib and paint viscosity combination is quite fine-tuned. Using the mops on a surface that is even mildly porous like the paper didn't show any signs of bleeding or oil around the edges. This is another great note on the chemistry of these paints, being well-rounded for many different applications. Like I mentioned earlier, these will not hold up against a paint or a chemical buff. These paints will be covered up with a couple coats of paint and removed with simple chemicals. So pick your application and location appropriately, knowing these few things. The top of the refill bottle made both mop and marker filling a breeze, so definitely give these a try in some empties. A color range of 10 seems a little bit small, but with all these refill bottle options, nothing's holding you back from mixing up some of your own colors. Your own paint combinations will have the strong backbone of street paint formula, while also sporting your own touch. I really liked this paint and had a great experience with all these mops. The 15mm marker showed some room for improvement, but overall I would definitely recommend trying out this awesome formula of paint. Head over to sprayplanet.com where you can find everything featured in this video. I will have links in the description to both the site and the specific street paint products I used. Also be sure to use the coupon code SIVEFUN to save 10% on your order. And by using that code, you will also support making more videos like this. I'll have to say thanks again to SprayPlanet for supplying the resources for this review. You may have noticed I featured a couple non-SIVE tags in this video, but there's definitely room for way more. With the seemingly non-stop request for writing some of your names, I figured I can incorporate that into my next review. If you want me to tag your name in a future review video, be sure to leave a comment down below with your tag name. I'm going to definitely use this for practicing a little bit more on my alphabet and showing some love back to you guys. If you found this video helpful and enjoyed watching it, be sure to spray that like button and consider joining the crew by subscribing. I make graffiti review videos like this, as well as tutorials, speed arts, and much more. Feel free to check out my latest review video and a random video that YouTube thinks you might like. That's going to do it for me, guys. Peace.